Hey there, in this video I'll show how you can create a proposal using AI. And that way you can have a proposal creation process takes you 1/10 the time that it took you before. And if you're really wondering whether it can save you that much time, well it can, and I want to show you just how it'll do it. So let's go ahead and dive in. So here we are using this tool called ChatGPT. This is an AI tool that works by you typing in a prompt and it gives a response back. Now this tool is not always available, but it is available for the most part because sometimes too many people use it. But if you want permanent accessibility to it, you can upgrade to Plus for about $20 a month. With that said, I use a free version because it almost never goes down for me. So I do recommend just starting with the free version, then going from there. Now, let's go ahead and talk more about how this tool can help you write proposals. So the first thing to know is that you want to be specific with your prompt so that way you can get a specific response back. Because you are likely creating a specific proposal, whether that be a grant proposal, a certain type of sales proposal, maybe it's even a DEI proposal, change management proposal, and then many other types. So for this example here, we'll show how you can create a grant proposal because that's a common type, and you can use this methodology for the many other proposals you may be working on. So now what we want to do is go ahead and create a proposal, and the more specific we are, the more specific response we'll get. So I'll type in here, create a grant proposal, and I want to say the word detailed here, because detailed is going to get ChatGPT and this AI tool to give us something more in depth, which is ultimately what we're looking for, to raise funds for the homeless community in San Diego in order for them to access, let's say, housing development. And this may not give us something perfect, and it could be because of the way we typed in the prompt. I'm just coming off with an idea off the top of my head, and we could be more specific to get a more specific result. And I'll show you how we can do that in just a second here. Now it is providing some data here. It's always important to fact check data that AI tools give you because it may not be accurate. It could just be plugging in this data from a source on the web that it crawled, so taking it, but it may not be a legitimate source. So that's something to keep in mind. Now you can see that includes the executive summary, the project description, even a budget here, which is pretty cool to see, and the funding request. Now, there are some areas of a grant proposal that it is missing, such as who are the stakeholders, who is the program manager. But overall, this is actually a pretty well put together initial proposal, at least for a foundation for one that we want to write and create. We'll have to plug in the rest of the details, but it is at least a good start. So some of the details that are also missing that I can think of is it doesn't have a timeline as well as a budget applied to that timeline. So let's go ahead and ask for that. So we'll say, update this proposal with a timeline of actionable steps across, say, four quarters, with a detailed budget for each of those quarters. Say, also add a list of stakeholders and key performance indicators. We're spelling everything right, and there we go. So now we have the updated proposal here. And what's cool about this is I've only typed in about three sentences in total, and I'm getting a significant output for those three sentences I put in. And you can keep expanding upon this in order to get more details for this proposal. So some things I can ask about are, what is the current homeless situation in San Diego like? So that way I can pull in more details around that and add it to the proposal. I can also ask ChatGPT, what are some great examples of new housing development for homeless populations? And that way I can use some examples that ChatGPT recommends, and I can ask for the best of those examples as well, and even get more detailed and why they're the best. And by getting all those details, I can then put together a pretty solid foundation again for this grant proposal that I'm putting together. And this applies to almost any type of proposal that you want to put together, unless it requires a lot of research from, let's say, your product team or engineering team, details that ChatGPT can't necessarily pull in for you. But what it can do is at least provide you, again, a foundation of an outline for those type of proposals. And in this case, it provides much more than a foundation of an outline, but a ton of material that I'll likely use as well. And that's incredible. So if I'm looking to write grant proposals, then I'm going to use ChatGPT as much as I can to assist me in my writing and making sure that I'm hitting every point that I want to, as well as getting a head start and being able to submit proposal after proposal to ensure that I can raise funding from the different funders that there are. So look at all these details that ChatGPT is able to, again, add. And some of the things I talked about earlier, so I can dive a bit deeper. So I can say, what is the homeless population in San Diego like? Now, this is a pretty broad question, but we'll start there and we could always dive deeper. So this is pretty broad and we could go deeper here if we want to. So we can say something like, what are example housing projects that have worked to help homeless people find shelter and see what it gives us in return? And now it's giving us some different examples, and we could dive deeper into all these examples. And housing first, tiny homes is another one. Now, we need to also verify these are accurate examples too. So we'll want to pop into Google and do our own research. But as you can see, it's moving the needle for us pretty quickly in terms of brainstorming and coming up with the right questions to ask, as well as just having a good understanding of what's been done within housing development and what's been done in helping the homeless population. And there we have it. We just gone through how you can use AI to help you generate successful proposals, conduct research for you for these proposals, and feel free to take a pause throughout this video so you can see the prompts that I entered to get a better understanding of how I was able to again conduct this research, write a whole proposal using AI and much more. And if you have any questions, make sure to go ahead and drop them in the comment section below. And if you feel like you enjoyed this video, make sure to like it. Go ahead and subscribe to our channel here at Technical Writer HQ. And that way you can get all of our tips and tricks on how to become a great writer. And I'll go ahead and see you in some of our other lessons and videos. Again, my name is Josh. I'm the founder of Technical Writer HQ, and we'll rock and roll from here. Cheers.